Hello friends, I, Dhairya Bhatia, welcome you to my YouTube channel Maths DN from Origin to Infinity. In this video, we are going to discuss a question of CSIR NET June 2019, Part B, Linear Algebra. And if you are preparing for any higher mathematics competitive exam such as CSIR NET, any set level examination, GATE, and looking for material, practice question bank with solved questions, topic wise distributed test series or combined test series, then you can find everything on the link given below. Moving on to the question. The question is, consider the vector space Pn of real polynomials in x of degree less than or equal to n and define a linear transformation t from P2 to P3 by t of fx equals to integration 0 to x ft dt plus f dash x. Then the matrix representation of t with respect to bases 1x, x square and 1x, x square and x cube is each year, or I can say after every 6 months, this type of questions are definitely asked in the examination. They are very simple to solve, just they are changing the basis and the transformation in each and every different mathematics examination. The options over here are A, a 3x4 matrix, B, 4x3 matrix with different entries. Similarly, option C and option D. I would recommend you to pause the video over here and first try this question by yourself. Also, notice that the transformation is from P2 to P3, which means that from a 3 to a 4, from a set of 3 elements to a set of 4 elements. So matrix has to be compulsorily 4x3. So from here only you can find that option A and option C will not be correct, just by applying one single result. Now only correct options can be B or D. Let us solve them. Solution. As I said earlier, it is given that T is a transformation from P2 to P3, so matrix has to be a 4x3 matrix. Also, the transformation is given to us as T of fx equals to integration 0 to x ft dt plus f dash x with respect to both the bases, basis for P2 1x x square and basis for P3 1x x square and x cube. You just have to do one simple thing. Take the basis from P2 and apply the transformation, and when you get the result, try to form that result with the help of the basis of P3. Let me show you how. For T1, it will be integration of 0 to x 1 dt plus 0, because the differentiation of 1 is 0 and this gives you the value of T1 equals to x. Now you have to make x with respect to the basis of P3. That will be 0 into 1 because there is no constant term, plus 1 into x, there is 1x only, plus 0 into x square, no term of x square, and 0 into x cube because no term of x cube. So you got the constants as 0, 1, 0, 0. Similarly, for t of x, it will be integration of 0 to x t dt plus 1, 1 is the differentiation of x. And on integrating, you get x square upon 2 plus 1. Again, you need to write this element in the form of basis of P3. That will be 1 into 1 because there is a constant term. 0 into x, there is no term of x, plus 1 by 2 into x square. The coefficient of x square is 1 by 2 and 0 into x cube. So you got another values 1, 0, 1 by 2 and 0. And now lastly, for x square, t of x square, which will be equals to integration of 0 to x t square dt plus differentiation of x square, that is 2x. This gives you the term x cube by 3 plus 2x. And now again writing this term in the form of basis of P3, we have 0 into 1 as there is no constant, plus 2 into x. There is a term of x with coefficient 2, plus 0 into x square, there is no term of x square, and 1 by 3 into x cube. This gives us 0, 2, 0, 1 by 3. And now, making a matrix out of that, we have 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1 by 2, 0, and 0, 2, 0, 1 by 3, which is nothing but option B. Thank you, and you can be a member of our social club and watch 280 plus videos on our YouTube channel. Get a complete study material for any higher mathematics competitive exam from our Telegram channel.